This is Piers Morgan Live. And I'll be joined now by Jacob Bernstein. And before we can get to you, Richard Barrett's over there is actually the guy who draws these amazing cartoon pictures all over the walls of this restaurant. Richard, good to see you.
Richard.
And you're actually drawing a portrait there of Nora Ephron. Wow.
Yes.
Fabulous.
Fantastic.
Fabulous. Jacob, you wrote a very moving piece for the New York Times recently about your mother. One of the things that really struck me about it, other than just the extraordinary gift she had for writing, was the strength and inspiration she drew from Mike McAleary's early death from cancer, when she herself, as she began to finish this script, knew that she was also dying of cancer. Tell me about that.
Well, I think that she saw him. Obviously, McAleary was not a perfect person. He was a somewhat problematic husband and a somewhat problematic colleague and perhaps too motivated by money. But he found in the last days of his life, particularly when the Louima story broke, he just went at it whole hog, and he knew he was sick. And I think that she was in a lot of ways in a race to get as much done as she could. Mm. You know, I think that that happens, and work becomes its own kind of medicine and an escape from illness. But my mother also didn't know she was dying until the end.
Right.
That is, you know.
She knew she was sick, and she didn't share that really with almost anybody.
Yes.
I mean, did you know, Tom?
Not a clue.
So it must have been a huge shock to everyone.
Yeah. Yes, it was. Yeah, it was. Look, this is part of the reason why Nora is one of the most amazing people in the world, because she knew that if she had told us early on in whatever problems she had, the first question everybody would ask her were, how are you feeling? Mm. And that was just, it's just no way to live. It just puts a cramp on the great adventure. And she right. didn't want that. And so, no, me and many other people who loved her very much didn't find out until literally 48 hours before.